All right, so we've got constructors now. So let's look at these methods that we've declared, but we haven't written any code for yet. So the first method that we declared was increment miles driven. The purpose of this method is to keep track of how many miles the car has driven by adding whatever the value is of this parameter variable to our instance variable, keeping track of the total number of miles driven. So we want to take the current value of the miles driven instance variable and add to it the value inside the parameter variable miles. This sum we then assign back to the instance variable miles driven. So take the current value of miles driven, add the value of the parameter variable miles, take that sum and store it back in the instance variable miles driven. We could totally do that. I mean, Java doesn't care, but it makes our lives more efficient if we actually write this a different way. So let's do that. This idea of adding a value to a variable and storing the resulting value back in the same variable is so common that there are special operators just so we can type less. So I'm going to comment this out, but I think it's important here because it's very clear. And instead, we're going to say this.milesDriven plus equals miles. This second line of code is not only easier to type, I think conceptually it makes more sense. Increment the instance variable miles driven by the value miles. So that's a nice way to write that. There's a plus equals, there's a minus equals, there's a star equals, there's a divide equals, there's these for like all the basic mathematical operators we would want. All right, let's look at get miles driven. So initially we just said, oh, we'll just return 0.0. We hadn't defined any instance variables yet. Now we can update this code to return the value of the instance variable miles driven. Nice. So we've implemented the first two methods that we initially wrote a few days ago. Now we can do this with incremental test-driven development. We can switch back to our BlueJ project window. And if everything is compiled, we can run tests again. And hey, good news, we're making progress. The first method, test increment miles driven, now passes. We have a little green check mark here. The other two still fail, but that's not too surprising because we haven't implemented them yet. So that's okay. But we're making progress. So let's close that. Let's go back here. The rest of the methods here, I provided the implementation for. We just commented it out. So now let's re-enable the code that I originally wrote for us. So we can remove the comment here inside of increment fuel consumed. And I'm using the plus equals operator here as well. We can remove the comment here for returning the instance variable, and then we can delete the return 0.0 piece. Those methods look pretty good now. And then here's the get mileage method. We can uncomment those two lines of code and delete the 0.0. And now we've got those three methods are now implemented. Cool, we are making progress. So we'll compile this again, and we'll switch back to our BlueJ project window, and we'll run the tests again. And no more are passing. All right, so if we click on test get mileage, it's different, but it's still failing. It's a little hard to see projected, but you can see it on your screen probably better. It says expected 25.0, but was 0.04. So we have a bug here somewhere. Something is still wrong. Here are ways that we tend to debug code. We could randomly change stuff and compile and run it again and hope it gets better. That is a very common technique that I observe. I don't recommend it. It's highly inefficient, and there are better ways to do things. Okay? We could read through the code, just visually inspect it, and try to figure out where our bug is, and that's a great first approach. Often we'll find the bug simply by pausing and carefully reading through our code, so I definitely recommend that as like a first tactic. A second tactic is we're like, probably something is wrong with this getMileage method, or maybe these instance variables, but I don't really know what, so let me just add a bunch of system.out.println's, and I'm gonna print the value of all my instance variables and like my calculations, and I'll run the code again and just see what gets printed. That is comfortable because it uses skills we're already familiar with, but there's a much better way in BlueJ that you weren't really able to do like when you were coding in Python. So I wanna show you like how we can do this in BlueJ in a more efficient way. BlueJ and many integrated development environments have debuggers. And debugger is a tool that lets us basically pause a program whenever we want and visually look at the values of everything. It is crazy powerful, and here's how we use it. So I'm just gonna do a quick intro to the debugger today. The way we tell the debugger where we want the code to pause is by setting what we call a breakpoint, which is represented by a stop sign in BlueJ. So in this white column on the far left of our editor window, mine has line numbers, yours probably doesn't unless you turn down that preference. I can click in that white column at the line of code where I want the program to pause, and that line will be highlighted red, and there's gonna be a little stop sign there. And what this means is when we execute our program and we get to this line of code, before this line of code is executed, the program is going to be paused and we're going to get to look at stuff and decide what happens next. Okay, super useful. So now that I've set this breakpoint, I can switch over here and run the tests again. And what happens is it pops up this new window called the BlueJ debugger. And it highlights in green the line of code that is about to be executed. Hasn't been executed yet, but it's about to be executed. This debugger window is super powerful. It tells me all the methods that have already been called. So for example, if I click here on test get mileage, I can see the test code and I can see in green the line of code that is currently being executed. I can click back to the get mileage. This is the method I'm trying to debug. In this pane, I can see all my instance variables and all their values. And this is super useful because I can see that miles driven is 100 and fuel consumed is 4. That's what I would expect. That's a good sign. And then there's buttons at the bottom, which let me step over one line of code or step into a method call or just start the program running again or just terminate the program, kill it, stop it. I'm gonna hit step. And when I do in this pane, I can now see the value of my new local variable mileage, and it is 0.04. So my instance variables are fine, but my calculation is off. Something is wrong with the line of code I just ran. Anyone see what my bug is? Yeah, what's my bug? Yeah, I divided this wrong. I took the number of gallons and divided it by the number of miles. That would give me a quantity in gallons per mile, but mileage is miles per gallon, miles for every gallon. I just did the division wrong. So I'm just gonna hit terminate here, and then I can go back to my code, and I can just swap this around to fix the bug. All right, we're just about out of time. So tomorrow we'll test this change, make sure it actually fits the test, and then we'll get our third and final test to pass.